Hey PC World fans, Adam here with Gordon. And Gordon, the 5800X3D just came out. The 12900KS is out. There's awesome CPUs to go around. The GPU prices are starting to come down. I think right now could be one of the best times to build a PC. Convince me I'm wrong.
Well, I got five reasons why you really want to wait. And I want to first give the caveat that, yeah, if you got to build a system now because you need a system, or maybe you got money and you need to spend it right now immediately and you can't spend it in 3 or 6 months, you got an awesome choice of hardware from GPUs to CPUs all around. But after you hear this list, I think you're going to think, you know what, I ain't going to build my system. I'm going to wait.
Okay, well, what's the first reason?
Well, this first one is going to be earth-shattering to people who follow technology, and new CPUs will be faster.
Wait, which new CPUs?
All of them, because it's they make new CPUs faster. Yes, I know you're saying no, duh. But, you know, Intel's Raptor Lake, its 13th gen, is expected to possibly have 24 cores. Clearly, Zen 4 is going to be one better than Zen 3. And I can guarantee you that whatever Ryzen 7000, which is what I think it'll be called, is going to be faster than Ryzen 5000. By 2000, in fact, it'll be much faster. So if you wait, the new CPU will be faster, yes. I can guarantee you that, in fact.
Okay, all right. Well, what's the second reason?
This is actually a very good one, I think, is DDR5. DDR5, when it came out with Alder Lake at the end of last year, was harder to find than a 3080, right? Okay. You had an easier time finding two 3080s in a Leprechaun riding a unicorn. It was easier to do that than it was to get DDR5. That meant 32 gigs of DDR5 was like $1,500 when it first came out. Something insane. People were like flipping houses so they could buy DDR5. Well, by the time the next generation CPUs come out, when AM5, when Zen 4, when Raptor Lake comes out, DDR5 is going to be probably pretty reasonable. It's already gone from an insane amount of money when it first came out late last year to now just kind of expensive. But you can get 32 gigs for, you know, $300, $200. You can get 16 gigs for a couple hundred bucks. And these are very, very high clock memory. It's only going to get faster. It's only going to get denser. It's only going to get cheaper. We hope. I can't predict if the aliens land tomorrow and enslave all of us, then yes, maybe memory will go up. But my guess is DDR5 will be extremely affordable compared to when it launched.
Okay. All right. Well, what's number three?
Number three, PCIe 5 SSDs. Right? So we have PCIe 4 SSDs. They're awesome. You know, maybe 7 gigs a second, you know, sequential transfer reads. You get the PCIe 5 next generation controllers and the next generation NAND. You could see a PCIe 5 potentially be, you know, almost twice as fast as a PCIe 4 SSD. So you're looking at 12 to 13 gigs a second transfer rates out of a single SSD on PCIe 5.
That is pretty crazy.
That's pretty crazy. And if you build now, your only option is to buy a PCIe 4 SSD.
Okay. All right. Well, what's number four?
Number four, new GPUs. This is a big deal. I mean, I love the fact that you can actually buy Radeon and GeForce GPUs now. Sometimes even under MSRP.
I just looked today.
Barely under.
Sometimes I just looked today.
They dip their nose under and they go, no, I'm going to go back up. But they're actually very reasonable. A lot of them extremely reasonable, especially compared to what it's been like for 24 months. Wind the clock forward 6-7 months when we get these new AM5, Zen 4, Raptor Lake, and you're going to be looking at possibly GeForce, you know, 4000 is what people hope. You're going to be looking at new Radeons. You're going to be looking at a new player called Intel, also hopefully shipping desktop GPUs. So you got three new lines of GPUs, possibly all fighting with each other for your money. As long as you can get them. And I think, you know, the trend has been for GPUs to get cheaper. It's only going to get cheaper, hopefully, again, unless the aliens land tomorrow.
Or a
zombie apocalypse. But in general, it's 80-90% chances that GPUs will be faster and cheaper by the end of this year.
Okay. Well, what's the last reason?
This last one is very interesting, and it may not work for everybody, but hopefully by the end of this year, at least on the back end of the year, we'll finally see ATX 3.0 power supplies. You can go watch our in-depth ATX 3.0 interview with Intel about the new spec and why you might want it, but I think there's a really good argument for wanting to have an ATX 3.0 power supply to go with your brand new high wattage GPU. And the main reason is you'll be able to buy an ATX 3.0 power supply that can handle a lot more graphics card and what that graphics card might do than try to make an old power supply work with it. So you just don't have to have as big a power supply, as powerful a power supply if you're going to go with the new spec versus trying to make an old spec. And you can't do that if you can't buy them. And there are no ATX 3.0 power supplies yet.
Yet.
So you add it all up. New CPU faster, DDR5 faster and more affordable, and more of it, PCIe 5 SSD faster, newer GPU, much faster, and a power supply that isn't 1200 watts to run it. All adds up to a pretty rockin' system that, you know what, if you can't wait 5 or 6 months, I understand, but I would recommend that if you can go the distance, you might just want to wait.
Okay, yeah. Good point. And I don't know, for me, I like building PCs, so, you know, maybe I won't wait. But maybe you will. Maybe Gordon made some good arguments for you to wait. Either way, we will see. Stay locked here for all the news, all the latest reviews and information as they come in. Thank you, Gordon, for trying to convince me on that. Did they convince you? Let us know in the comments, and we will see everyone later. Thank you. Bye.